in Long Beach called, I changed the name to Richard Kyle, the bookseller was the name officially, and then they called it Wonderworld for a while. And they were importing comics from all over the world. They'd have these parties out there, and Jack would hold court of a future of comics. Remember the time we took Jack to the Underground Comic Shop? we took our Jack on a tour with the Underground Comic Shop. And he walks in to this one shop, and there's no smoking on. He's got a smoldering cigar. They're burning incense in the shop, but you can't have the cigar smoke. And they're like chasing Jack out. You gotta finish that outside, sir. But he loved the fact that the Underground Comics, some of those guys were doing graphic novels an issue at a time. He loved that.
And it was also one of the things behind you guys, because as the novel, yeah. You've seen all these European books that were beautifully printed and beautifully published, and you thought that that was the way to go. That was the way that in the days of the mob and spirit world were supposed to go, but apparently he didn't know how to do that.
Well, he didn't want to do any reform, really.
No, look, they were making money with Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, everything else was a pain.
So what do you think about the Bob Show?
Loved doing that. He was very proud of Jack. Did a couple of appearances, like the
right.
Like sketch artist. Yeah, no, he was very pleased with that. All the people in that cast, he decided Bob King was a huge pain in the ass. Yeah, he was very pleased about that. Yes. Page and something special to him. I think every page meant something special to him, but the totality of the story was more important. I don't think something, you know, some of the pages you see around of Jack's unpublished stuff from Marvel, full pages of like, you know, Odin, Watcher. Jack would finish a page and Roz would come in and say, "That's too good to give to Marvel." And Jack would say, "Okay, give it to her, Keith," and he'd draw a new page to replace it. And sometimes she'd come in and see the new page and say, "Here, take the old one back, I want this new one." But he drew some of those pages twice and gave them to Roz for her private collection. Next question?
In Argo, can you say anything about Argo, and do you think that Larry Clark or Michael Park was any kind of characterization of Jack Kirby?
I didn't see Argo, actually.
Not even close.
Can you say anything about what the real Argo project involvement?
I don't remember exactly. I'm not sure how much Jack involvement Jack had with that. Because I think, didn't he already do the drawing?
He did the drawings in 1979, 1980 with Barry Gellert.
Yeah, Eric, right. Yeah. So I don't know if he had drew them specifically for that.
No, Barry had opted the movie rights to this novel, and somehow he hooked up with Jack and asked Jack to draw each of the main characters and the good guys and the bad guys in the novel as only Jack could imagine them and envision them. And so Jack did that, and then later on, somebody got hold of a script that Barry had commissioned to be written, and that was the basis for the Argo, the script was the basis for the Argo story, and then the drawings came.
Right, the drawings were already there.
Right.
Yeah. So no, Jack didn't specifically sit down and draw those drawings for the CIA.
That Larry Clark thing, I mean Michael Clark,
that was it. It came first.